Hello there, good morning. You're watching Proactive London. Joining us today from Faron Pharmaceuticals, we do have the Chief Executive, Dr. Markku Jalkanen. So a very warm welcome to you, because two big news releases that we're going to discuss in detail today together. First of all, I want to talk about Bexmarilimab, these promising anti-tumour activity results that you're going to discuss with us today. So a warm welcome. So take us through what you've learned so far, if you would.
Thank you very much. It's nice to be here again. So we have had this ongoing MATINS trial, where we are treating really, and this is really important, people who have gone through all the previous lines of treatments and have had no options anymore. There we have tested 10 solid tumor cohorts. And now today, when we had a data cut at 6 months of observations, how they're doing, we have learned that we have a significant population who are really good responders to the treatment. And all of these patients had a progressive condition. Now, out of these 10 different solid cancer tumors, we had a clear signal from a cutaneous melanoma patients, gastric cancer, and the cholangiocarcinoma. And all of them are really a refractory patients. So obviously, this is really important milestone for us really to move on now to the final dosing optimization and then expand the cohorts to the point where we can go back to the regulators and ask what it really takes to take this product in these indications to the market.
Right. And in terms of a realistic timeline, how would this work then, Markku?
I would think that around 6 months from now, or maybe more, we will have the regulatory meetings. And obviously then we would learn what size of the final trials we would actually need to really do in order to get the conditional permissions really to start really to treat these patients already beyond our trials. And they may set up some conditions to get the final approval, but that's normal with the cancer patients, especially with ones who had no options anymore.
So we're talking about 141 people here, and as you say, they had no other options.
That's very true. And it's important to also understand that many of them already have gone through previous immuno-oncology meetings, like anti-PD-1, anti-PD-L1, or even CTL4 antibodies. And they are still refractory to those treatments. And now they come to our trial and we can see this benefit. Wow. I just find this very remarkable at the moment.
Yeah, quite right. Absolutely. And what are you still trying to learn then here exactly?
Well, we learned some 6-8 months ago that there is a soluble form of this target molecule, Clever-1. And we believe that that is a very significant player in here. And we need to remove that as well, and not only the myeloid cells we originally are targeting. And that may take a higher dosing frequency than we have today at our trial. And that is a 3-week interval. So we are going now down 2-week and 1-week intervals, and we would like to have those results available before we move on to the pivotal part.
Right. Well, we wish you all the best of luck with that. We'll be
thinking of everyone
on the trials, of course, as well. Moving on, we're going to talk about the US rights to a patent related to Traumakine.
Right. Yeah, it was interesting that we actually encounter a kind of a patent like this, because the original filing was already done some 40 years ago. It is a patent for a cDNA of interferon-beta, which you need in order to manufacture the interferon-beta for the therapeutic use. And we wanted to have this license from Bayer in order to really confirm that we have access for our own product also in the US market. So it's kind of a building up the prior, a proprietary position, which we had already in US. It is important for us really to secure that all these key stories are really available once we start to get the results from the Hibiscus trial.
Mm-hmm. And we're talking about respiratory failure and organ protection here, aren't we?
And not only that, there are some very interesting new development coming up. And one of them is really related to this CAR-T treatment of the cancer patients, where after the giving back the T cells, they actually develop this cytokine response syndrome. And we believe that interferon-beta is actually a key ingredient really to slow down and actually could help the patients really go through this process. So I think we will find out rather new, a very exciting applications also for Traumakine, not only the organ failures like lungs and some other ones, but really, really becoming an important natural defense molecule in a number of these conditions where the cytokines are really expressed in high quantities.
Goodness me. In regards to what you want to say to your shareholders today, Markku, give us the last word from you.
This results from a MATINS trial. It's a groundbreaking. This is the very first standalone myeloid-based treatment on this planet. We believe that it will really have an interesting opportunity to combine with the existing treatments. And it really holds up the promise that we need to control the myeloid cells within the tumor environment and in the patient's body so that we can have a full activation of the immune system. So we are really are looking forward to a very exciting results in years to come.
Sounds good. Thank you very much indeed for your time. I know you're extremely busy there at Faron Pharmaceuticals today. Thank you.
Thank you. Bye now.